Welcome back, dear students. So in the last video, I have learned about heredity. We have just started with the lesson introduction, that is heredity and evolution. And in that, you have learned about heredity and hereditary changes. Now, let us now go for the next part of the lesson, that is transcription, under transcription, translation and translocation. There is one question, that is, can you tell? In that, two questions are asked. Let me answer those questions first, and then we will start in the next video about transcription, translation and translocation. So let us deal with the first question, that is, sketch and explain the structure of DNA and various types of RNA. Fine. So now let us let me answer this first question, that is, sketch and explain the structure of DNA. So if you remember, last year you have studied about the DNA structure, that the DNA is a double helical structure. Double helix means there are two strands for the DNA, and they are in the form, they are coiled in such a way that it looks like a helix. So that is why Watson and Crick had proposed this model, and it was called as a double helix. So you can see it is like a ladder also, you can see, or it's like a rail. Fine. Now this is a double helix, and what it comprises of? It is mostly made up of the nucleotide sequencing. Now you can see this black line which I have drawn. So these are nothing but the nucleotide sequence of one strand is joined to the nucleotide strand of the second one. Fine. So these two strands are joined due to nucleotide sequencing. And what does this nucleotide comprises of? Nucleotide comprises of three different things. This is just revision what I am doing. Last year you have already studied about this. So nucleotide comprises of phosphoric acid. Fine. Then it comprises of deoxyribose sugar, nitrogenous bases, and nitrogenous bases are of two types. They are purines and pyrimidines. Fine. So purines again are of two types. They are adenine and guanine. So, and pyrimidines are cytosine and thymine. And base pairing or the nitrogenous bases, how they are pairing here in this case is adenine always pairs with thymine. Okay, and guanine always pairs with cytosine. So adenine is bonded to thymine with double hydrogen bonds, whereas guanine is bonded with cytosine with triple hydrogen bonds. So this is how a double helix or DNA model is, which was proposed by Watson and Crick. So this is the answer to the first question, half of the question. Second one is various types of RNA. So RNA, if you remember, RNA is also called as ribonucleic acid. So ribonucleic acid, depending upon its function, they are of three different types. Okay, they are mRNA, tRNA and ribosomal RNA. So what does, first of all, you should know how RNA differs from DNA. RNA is a single strand, whereas DNA is a double-stranded structure, whereas RNA is a single strand. And instead of thymine, it consists of uracil. It also consists of four nitrogenous bases, that is adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil. So in place of thymine, uracil is present. So the three types, first one is mRNA, depending upon the function. Now how is the mRNA? mRNA is also called as messenger RNA. So what it actually does, messenger RNA carries the information of the protein synthesis from DNA, which is present in the nucleus, to the cytoplasm where there is ribosome. Okay, so since it carries the information from one place to another, it is also called as a messenger RNA. Okay, and whatever code is there, it is there present on the messenger RNA. Second is ribosomal RNA. So ribosomal RNA is actually present in the cytoplasm, and it is actual site of protein synthesis, where protein synthesis is taking place. You are going, now why I am telling into detail is because we have to study about the transcription, translation and translocation. That is why you need to remember or recall all these three different types of RNAs. Then third one is the transfer RNA. So transfer RNA is also present in the cytoplasm. And what does transfer RNA does? So transfer RNA actually transfers amino acid, okay, from the cytoplasm to the ribosome. Now how it carries a amino acid? So it detects or reads the codon which is present, or codon and all you will be studying in the next video. So it is according to the message on the messenger RNA, it carries the amino acid towards the ribosomal RNA. So this you have studied last year about the about DNA and RNA. So this in a nutshell I tried to tell you. So if you want, you can just, you know, refer to standard 9 textbook. So if you have to answer this question, you will have to answer in this manner. So that is why I stressed on this question. Next question is, explain the meaning of genetic disorder and give names of some disorders. Now genetic disorders, first of all you should know why genetic disorders are taking place. Now genetic disorders takes place due to various reasons, like it might be due to abnormalities in the chromosomes or maybe the mutations in the genes. Now how abnormalities can occur in chromosomes? So you have learned about this also last year, that abnormalities in chromosomes are maybe due to increase or decrease in the number of chromosomes, so which is leading to the numerical changes in the chromosomes. Okay, fine, this is first thing. Second is deletion of any part of the chromosome. So one of the part of the chromosome might be deleted. Or third thing, translocation of any part of the chromosome. That means one part of the chromosome is being translocated to some other part. So that is also called a translocation of chromosome. So this is regarding the abnormalities in the chromosome. Next, second thing I talked about is the mutation in the genes. So mutations might be in a single gene causing monogenic disorders, or maybe at the same time many genes are getting affected. So this is also called a polygenic disorder. Now next part of the question is, give names of some disorders. So let me talk about first the chromosomal abnormalities and then the genetic disorders. Okay, so chromosomal abnormalities you have already studied, depending upon the number, changes in the number of chromosomes. Okay, increase or decrease in the number of chromosomes. You have learned about Down syndrome, or also called as trisomy, wherein there is one extra chromosome for the 21st pair. Instead of two or a pair, there is one more chromosome. So it is also called as trisomy, or trisomy of the 21st pair. Fine. Then you have also learned about the Turner syndrome, and wherein it is having only one X, 44 plus X condition, that is the in case of the female, whereas Klinefelter syndrome is one extra X chromosome the males have, that is also called as Klinefelter. So it is 44 plus XXY. So this you have learned about the chromosomal abnormalities. Next is let me talk about the monogenic disorders. Now monogenic disorders, I have told you, it is the change in a single gene which may cause that gene into a defective gene, and so even it might cause some of the disorders. So what are the different types of disorders it has? So nothing but Hutchinson disease. Okay, so these names are given in the 900 textbook. You can refer back. Hutchinson disease, Tay-Sachs disease, galactosemia, then phenylketonuria is there. Then sickle cell anemia you have learnt about. Then also sickle cell cystic fibrosis. Then hemophilia, or maybe albinism, and night blindness. So all these are monogenic disorders, whereas you have learned about polygenic disorders like cleft lip, cleft palate, then constricted stomach, or spina bifida, which is a, you know, a defect in the spinal cord, etc. And other diseases like even diabetes, blood pressure, then you have obesity, then we have albinism, asthma, obesity, heart disorders, blood pressure, or diabetes. So these are some of the polygenic disorders. Fine. So these two questions I have tried to answer. So you can write the answers for the question. Fine. So in the next video, I will talk in detail about transcription, translation, and translocation. So till then, thank you.